So I got a friend that has some coworkers that's kind of asking questions. So I'm putting this out there. So this is my program. This is what I'm doing right now. I powerlift, and I may not be the strongest powerlifter, and I might have had setbacks and injuries, but it hasn't stopped me. I continue to push forward. So this is my program that I built for myself according to my needs and what I was lacking at the time. There's a bunch of different programs out there to run. I'm not saying this is the right way or the wrong way. This is just the way that I do it for my specific needs. And for those of you who are curious or wondering, you know, here it is. You can do it with me, or you could just watch to see how my progress goes. Either I get stronger or I don't. So the program is basically simple. It's consisted off a percentage of mesocycles. Mesocycles is basically a mini cycle, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 1 week of a program or a split that you do for a certain length of time for a certain percentage. And then it resets percentages, or when it resets, the percentages or the exercises change out. Google it, look it up, read it. I'm not going to go into too much depth. It's called a mesocycle. So the percentages on my routine for my building. So there's two different phases to this. There's a building, and then there's a peaking. This is the building. So right here, I'm going to talk about the building phase of my program. This is for the squats. So the building phase is 70% to 80%. And that's of your one rep max for your squat, your bench, and your deadlift. Right now, we're particularly talking about squats. So if 100 is 100%, it's easier for you to follow percentage. So if your one rep max is 100%, you're going to start off doing 70 pounds. And then you could either do three mesocycles and go 70, 75, 80. You can do four mesocycles for 70, 73, 76, 79, or 80. The percentage doesn't have to be exact, and you can break it down to five or six mesocycles and go up by 1 or 2% every time. But the mesocycle runs for 3 weeks for 70 to 80%. Now, as far as it goes for squats, and the way that it goes is you're going to write down the exact amount of sets that you do. And the reps, how it goes is you do two sets of 10, you do two sets of 8, two sets of 6, and two sets of 5. And you're going to write these numbers down. You're going to put down, you know, 135 for 10, 185 for 10, 225 for 8, 255 for 8, 275 for 6, 295 for 6, 315 for 5, 345 for 5. These are just numbers. But you're going to end your top set, your very last set, with 70%. So going back to the numbers and the percentages. So you would basically start with, let's say, 20 pounds, and then 25 pounds, and 30 pounds, and 45 pounds, and 50 pounds, and 60 pounds, and work your way up to your very last set is 70 pounds for 5 reps. You're going to write this down, and you're going to do those exact reps for those exact sets for 3 weeks straight. The reason being is it takes roughly 3 to 4 weeks for the body to adapt to any kind of new stress, regardless of the stress. So week one, you're going to feel strong. If you pick the proper percentage, it should feel fairly easy. Week two, it's probably going to feel heavy because you're going to be tired and worn out from week one. You're not recovered yet. You're not used to it. Week three, you're adapting, so it should be a little bit easier. Not really easy, not really light. It's just doable. Week four is whenever your body should be pretty much adapted. So here's the new mesocycle when you go up in percentage. So whether you go up to 72 pounds or 75 pounds or 78 pounds, remember the pounds are just through percentage. So you go off of percentage, not pounds. And then you pick your next mesocycle. If you picked it correctly, it should feel how the first week felt and give your body time to adapt for your ligaments, your tendons, your joints, and everything else. So, and that's your sport specific. The sport specific is basically to target the exact movement that you're going to be performing for the powerlifting meet, which is a squat. You're going to do every rep exactly the same, perfectly. I'm not saying there's a perfect form out there, but what's perfect for your form? Your back leverages. You might have a long torso, short torso. You might have long quad, short quads, long shins, short shins, It just depends on your leverages, thin abdominal, thick abdominal, just whatever. So you practice perfect form for your shape 100% from the lightest weight to the heaviest weight, from the first rep to the last rep. You practice perfect. Perfect practice equals perfect form. Even when you're under heavy load and it gets away from you, or you're under a new stress or new load, your body will naturally want to go into that movement, given everything goes correctly. So next, we move on to our progressive overload. So we pick a movement that best imitates our weakest point of the lift. It could be good mornings, and that's what I typically use, is a good morning with bands. So it could be we'd use good mornings with a safety squat bar, but it could be anything. It doesn't matter. Whatever your weakest point and your weakest area is. For me, it's my lower back because I have a long torso. So I do good mornings, and I do 3 sets of 6 on this. And if I'm working with 125 pounds, like in the video, then I'm going to do a set of 95 for 6 with 30 pounds worth of band tension on each side, whatever that is at the top, I'm not sure. And then I'm going to do a middle between the 125 and 95, and then the last set, I'm going to do the 25. And then what I do after that is I mark that down, the top set. Next week I come in and I try to go up by 5 pounds, at least by 5 pounds. Might be more, might be, you know, less, but I try to go up by at least 5 pounds. If I can't go up by actual weight, then I move the band tension up. The band tension is for progressive overload. So if you're bent over, a good morning's when you basically bend over and hinge at the hips all the way over. So if you are bent over and your lower back is at its absolute most weakest and you're at the most strain and risk for injury here in a weak position, the bands lighten the load as you go down, reducing the risk of injury. And as you stand up, they tighten and increases overload, tension at the top. So you're allowed to train your back with heavier weights at the top, which works on your overload, which gives you a lighter resistance at the bottom, which decreases the risk of injury. This is the reason why I use it. Not saying this is the only reason or the way to use bands. This is the way that I use bands. If you take in consideration of this, okay, if I give you a dumbbell and you were to curl a 20-pound dumbbell, with the amount of force it takes to move that 20-pound dumbbell, you cannot move a 60-pound dumbbell with the same amount of force. I take that 20-pound dumbbell from you, I put it in your hand, the 60 pounds will not move the same amount of force that you applied to that 20-pound dumbbell. So you have to apply more force. The way that bands work is when you're at the bottom, you only have to apply the amount of force of the weighted on the bar. As you stand up, you have to apply more force through the range of motion, allowing you to accelerate. It doesn't look like you're accelerating. It doesn't feel like it, but you're moving faster through the movement. It's like if I took that 20-pound dumbbell as you're picking it up and I start to push down on it as you're trying to curl it, you will then have to lift up harder. And if you're moving this fast, if I push down and let go, you're now moving much quicker. So you're progressively loading more weight as you move. And I try to go up by 5, 10 pounds, 20 pounds, whatever is doable for that week and that load. And depending on what movement it is, it might be more specific, like a close grip bench press, and that kind of gives me what my lockout strength is. So if I'm doing, you know, 280, 250 on the bench, and then I'm overloading with close grip bench press with a slingshot, and I'm doing 295 for 3, well, I know once my elbows get past my chest and that slingshot's no longer giving me assistance, I can lock out 290, 295 for 3. So now that I know that my lockout strength is there, now I have to work on my lower end strength. So I know here is strong enough, but now from here to here, what do I do to get that stronger? So I know I have the top end strength. Now all I have to do is work on the lower end strength. So now let me build up my lower end strength and figure out where my weakest muscle is and build that up. And that's your weak point. And you got to build up your weak point. So you're only as strong as your weakest muscle. So that's where bands come in. They allow you to be safer with a heavier load to find where your lockout is, or to find out what you know, can do in a safer range of motion. It allows you to do more with a heavier load in a safer range of motion due to the fact that it deloads at the bottom and it loads at the top. And there's multiple ways to use bands. There's so many different ways. There's no one way to use them. So this isn't like, hey, this is what this guy said and he's an idiot because, you know, that's not right. It's the way I use them. You use them however you want. Look at the conjugate system. There's a whole Louis Simmons. There's a whole deal in the conjugate system and bands and equipped lifting and everything else. And I'm not here to argue with people. I'm just telling you what I do. So then from there, I move on to assistance work. Resistance work is just basically bodybuilding. It's hypertrophy. It's to build the muscles that will be assisting the movement. So if I'm working on my quad strength because I'm doing squats, I want to target my quads. So I might do close stance leg press for 5 sets of 20 with the same weight every set. Or I might do leg press 5 sets of 20 or leg extensions 5 sets of 20 or buffalo bar 5 sets of 20, like front squats. I'm going to do something that targets the muscles that I feel need work for size. A bigger muscle is always capable of being a stronger muscle. So if I build that muscle size, I'm also building the ability for that muscle to carry a bigger load. And then it also gives you more endurance, and it gives you better opportunities to condition the joints and ligaments and tendons with more blood flow, because you're not going heavy. If you're going heavy on a set of 20, 5 sets of 20, you need to reconsider that and drop it down. This is just muscle pumping, like bodybuilding. Just get as much blood in there as you can. And this movement could be whatever you need for whatever part of your body. So if you're doing chest or deadlifts or whatever it is, this movement right here for me is, it's either hack squats, leg press, or leg extensions. It could be whatever I need. Whatever I feel is going to give me the most bang for the buck and give me the most results, and that's what I go for. Since I'm targeting quads on this day, I do the leg press or hack squat or something of the sort. Now, if I was doing hamstrings, that's a different story. That's for deadlift. I'll go over that on Monday. So that's basically the program for my squats. I'm going to do another one about my bench on Tuesday. I'll do one about my deadlifting and assistance work on Monday. And I'll do another one about my assistance work on Friday. Friday is just basically bodybuilding. In every video, I'm going to talk about the mesocycle and the percentages for whoever doesn't see whichever video. I'm going to have this little part in here too. And remember, this is my program that I built for myself. And you could talk shit, say it's wrong and why it's not going to work and how it's incomplete or incorrect. And that's not the way you do that and blah, 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 blah. And follow along and watch. And I'm either going to get stronger and you're wrong, or I'm going to get weaker and you're right. Either way it goes, doesn't matter to me because I love working out and I experiment and try, because nothing's going to work forever. Everything changes. Doesn't matter what you do and how well you do it. Eventually that routine will not work no more. And there's a bunch of them out there. So just look into it. But this is what I'm doing. And trying to get back on the platform. This is how I'm going about it.
Young money. Yeah. So. I tell her, now down, pop that pussy for a real nigga. I already know that life is deep, but I still dig her. Niggas is jealous, but really I could care less. I'm in Hell's Kitchen with an apron and a headnet. Devil on my shoulders, the Lord is my witness. So on my Libra scale, I'm weighing sins and forgiveness. What goes around comes around like a hula hoop. Karma is a bitch, well just make sure that bitch is beautiful. Life on the edge, I'm dangling my feet. I tried to pay attention, but attention paid me. Haters can't see me, nosebleed seats. And today I went shopping, and talk is still cheap. I rock to the beat of my drum set. I've been at the top for a while and I ain't jumped yet. But I'm Ray Charles to the bullshit, and I jump up on that dick and do a full split. She just started to pop it for a nigga and look back and told me, baby, it's real. It's real. And I say I ain't doubt you for a second. I squeeze it and I could tell how it feel. How it feel. I wish we could take off and go anywhere but here, baby, you know the deal. And she bad, so maybe she won't, but shit, then again, maybe she will. Yeah, do it for the realest niggas in the fucking game right now. She will, yeah. Do it for the realest niggas in the fucking game right now. She will, she will, she will. Maybe for the money and the power and the fame right now. She will, she will, she will. Do it for the realest niggas in the fucking game right now. She will, she will, she will, she will. Yeah. I tell her. Now gone, pop that pussy for me. Haters can't see me, but them bitches still looking for me. And you could take that to the bank and deposit that. Put your 2 cents in and get a dollar back. Some people hang you out to dry like a towel rack. I'm all about I give the rest of the vowels back. I like my girl thick, not just kinda fine. Eat her till she cry, call that wine and dine. Try to check me and I'ma have them checking pulses. They say choose wisely, that's why I was chosen. Rocking like asphalt, it's the cash vault. Looked in the face of debt and took its mask off. Now I like my house big and my grass soft. I like my girl face south and her ass north. But I'm Ray Charles to the bullshit. Now hop up on that dick and do a full split. She just started to pop it for a nigga and look back and told me, baby, it's real. It's real. And I say I ain't doubt you for a second. I squeeze it and I could tell how it feel. How it feel. I wish we could take off and go anywhere but here, baby, you know the deal. And she bad, so maybe she won't, but shit, then again, maybe she will. Yeah, do it for the realest niggas in the fucking game right now. She will, yeah. Do it for the realest niggas in the fucking game right now. She will, she will, she will. Maybe for the money and the power and the fame right now. She will, she will.